Hello and welcome to our sixth video in our mod tool tutorial series. I'm Dragon and today I'm going to tell you about effects, how to use them, how to use the configurator of effects and how to use effect namespace. The provinces editor is the first editor in which you can actually find button which opens the configurator of effects. As you can see here, like in many other editors, this is the label one province effects, country and province effects or one country effects. These are types of different effects. There are actually more types and all of different effect types are configured separately. So let me open the first one, province effects editor. And this is our main configurator of effects window. Here in the upper left part you can see which effects you are setting up right now. In this case we are setting up one province effects. And here in the middle of the top panel there is a drop-down with all effects that you have set up in the effect namespace. We are going to talk about effect namespace later in this video. For now, let me show you how to set up a single effect. But in order to set up an effect, first you have to understand what effects are. And this is important because effects are used in multiple editors here, and they provide you with many options. So for example, in this case, we are setting up effects for this province. And for effects, context is very important, because in this case, we are configuring effects only for this selected province, and they will come into effect when the game starts. And they will stay applied to this province throughout the whole game. So, for example, I can decide that this province needs to be more unhappy than usual. So let me open this dropdown here and choose Unhappiness Target Province. And that effect means that it affects target unhappiness in the selected province. So let me add by clicking this plus sign here, this effect to our effects list. Here to the left, there will be all effects that you add. And you can add more than one in this case. There are some other editors in which you can only add one effect at a time. But in this case, you can add more than one and they all will be applied at the start of the game to the selected province. You can also click here on this button to delete an effect. And let me show you how to set up a single effect like this Unhappiness Target Province effect. After you select an effect, its details will be shown here on the right side of the configurator of effects. And there are many options here, and I'm going to go through them one by one. First of all, usually on the very top of the effects details, there is value input field with the name of the modifier or value that you are providing. So in this case, we would like to increase the target unhappiness in this province by 15. So I can just type 15 here and it will modify the province. This ticker here is hidden, determines whether this effect will be visible in game for the player or not. If you choose to hide it for some reason from the player, select this ticker here. Now this line here, kind of effect, determines a very important thing. From this drop-down, you can select how long the effect will stay in place and whether it can be removed later. For example, if you choose forever option, this effect will never end. So this province will always have its unhappiness target increased by 15. If you choose the constant option, this effect will also stay here, affecting this province, unless it is removed somehow. But in this case, for province effects, we do not have a way to remove them. It works only, for example, for actions or buildings or projects. So things that could be ended, removed, demolished or cancelled. This option here, time, as you may imagine, makes the effect temporary. And after selecting it, it is important to go to this line here, duration, and type your desired duration. For example, 365 days. And duration of your desired number of days means that unhappiness target in this province will be increased from the beginning of the game by 15 for 1 year. You can also select the falling kind of effect. It works similarly to time. You also need to type duration for the falling effect. But falling means that with each passing day, this value will be proportionally decreased. So, if I, for example, type here 15 days of duration of this effect, on the first day, this effect will modify our target unhappiness in this province by 15. On the second day, it will modify only by 14. And so on and so forth. Until on the last day of its duration, it will modify our target unhappiness only by 1. So this is a very useful kind of effect if you want to make your effect diminish over time. You can also scale your effects. Scaling effects is useful when modifying various parameters. And here is a dropdown that lets you choose the scale type. So for example, we can say that we would like to scale our target unhappiness by the province count of the country. So if I select this option here, province count, this number, this value here of unhappiness modifier will be multiplied by the province count of the country in which this province exists. So if this country has, for example, 3 provinces, our unhappiness modifier would be 45 instead of 15. So scaling usually means that you would have to input much lower modifier here. For example, if I would like to scale our unhappiness target in province by the population, I would probably need to input such a low fraction here, because country's population can be, for example, 1 million people. And if our country's population is 1 million people, then multiplying it by this fraction would mean that our unhappiness target increases by 100. And 100 is maximum unhappiness. So it is already, as you can see, pretty big. Let me choose, for example, for this effect forever, because I would like to modify unhappiness in this province by 15 for forever, without any scaling. In this line, you can choose modifier type, which is also extremely important for effects, especially if they are affecting parameters. In this dropdown, you can see 4 options. Add option simply increases the parameter by the value provided here. Multiply simply multiplies the chosen parameter by this value. So, for example, if my current unhappiness in this province is 10, and I would type here 15, my unhappiness after applying this effect would increase to 150. Set. It's a tricky modifier type because it overrides the basic parameter value. So for example, if I would have my unhappiness target, my current unhappiness target at, let's say, 35, and I would use the modifier type of set, it would change to 15. And percent modifier type, which is pretty useful when creating modifiers, for example, in projects or buildings, percent modifier type simply means that this value here is a percentage value, ranging from 0 to 100. And in this case, it would mean that our unhappiness target in province increases by 15%. So it is multiplied by 1.15. But in this case, I am going to simply choose the add modifier type, so that my unhappiness target in the province is increased by flat 15. If you instead choose to, for example, scale your effect by something from this dropdown here, you could also consider using dynamic scaling ticker and enabling it. This ticker here means, after being enabled, that when the scale value changes, your effect value also changes with it. So, for example, if a country gains another province or loses another province, this value here is multiplied by the new province count, thus dynamic scaling. And of course, if you are not using scaling, this ticker does nothing. As well as if you are not using a kind of effect time or falling, duration value does absolutely nothing. So now we have covered the basics of configuring your effect. Let me scroll down here to some other options. Those tickers here determine how the effect is visualized in the game. This option here is colorized, means that your value in the game will be shown in either green or red, depending whether it is positive or negative. If you have isColorized enabled, you can also use isColorReversed. If you enable it, positive values will be red and negative values will be green. And that's exactly what we would like in our unhappiness target effect and parameter, because high unhappiness is bad for us. Those two tickers here, isShowValue and isShowFlag, determines whether the effect in the game will show its value and show its flag if it's affecting another country. So in this case, show flag will not do anything. And here we have some other effect configuration. Its name is effect name key, so it's localization key, and its icon name, so you can customize the icon for your effects. And here at the bottom, we have an important part of configuring effects and balancing the game. Let me go back here to the top and choose the population scale type and input here, for example, a fraction like that. So like I told you before, if my country has 1 million people, my unhappiness target would now be modified by 100. And that is a lot. So I would like to create some kind of a limit for my unhappiness modifier. And I can do it right here after enabling this ticker here, is flat or scale value. After enabling it, both this value here, scaled, is calculated, and this value here is taken into consideration. And after typing here, for example, 25, the game will now determine which one of those two values, 25 flat value or the scaled value, is lower. And the lower wins. So basically, if 25 is lower, our unhappiness target will be modified on this province by 25. If our scaled value, so this value here multiplied by population, is lower, then this value will be affecting our unhappiness target in this province. And of course, you could choose that you would like to have greater value affecting your province. So now I can tick this ticker here, enable it, and now the game will decide whether 25 is greater or this value calculated here by multiplying this number and population. And the higher, the greater number, the greater value will win. But for my effect here, I do not want to use the flat or scale value because I do not want to scale my value at all. So let me just revert back to my unhappiness modifier of 15. And also, at the very bottom here of the configurator of effects, there is the update name localization from namespace ticker. And it is important ticker that I recommend you to leave checked in all your effects, because it means that this effect here in this configurator effects is still connected to our effect namespace. And what is effect namespace and why it is so important, I am going to tell you right now. But first, always remember to save your configurator of effects. Those values here, those effects, are not saved automatically. So you always need to click save here and close your configurator of effects. And now, when I go back to our Open One Province Effects Editor and click it, I will have my unhappiness target province effect just like I have set it up before. All right, so what is effect namespace? It is a special tool, an editor, and you can find it right here, effects namespace. And here you can configure all effects in the game and choose their icon, their name, how they are calculated by default, what is their preferred behavior, and you can save them and update them later. And if you update them, you will update all your previously configured effects also, if they have the ticker that I have mentioned enabled. So, how to configure your effects? That is actually pretty straightforward. First, you need to choose effect category type. And here are all categories of effects that we have created for Realpolitiks II. Let me choose, for example, one country effect. And now, after selecting the category type, I can choose my effect type, which basically means choosing the right script for my effect. And this is the list of all effect scripts. So, for example, let me choose change money effect here. Pretty straightforward effect. In my mod, money will work exactly like in Realpolitiks 2 base game. So it will affect my money parameter, increase it and decrease it. So I can simply type here effect localization key, but I'm not going to use the localization for this. I'm just going to input here simply money, because that is the name I would like for my effect to have. And now I can also choose effect icon. And we have here a dropdown with all of our effects icons. I can also type here money, and that will allow me to simply sort through all icons with money in their name. So I can simply choose money icon. And now I have the visualization of the effect prepared and its behavior, change money effect. And now I can set up some other parameters of this effect. In this case, I do not need to enable this ticker here for dynamic scaling, because money only affects the base parameter and it cannot change over time. It simply happens instantaneously. I will leave the show value. I do not need show country, but I would like this effect to be visible, so I am not going to enable hidden ticker also, but I'm going to enable colorized ticker, because getting more money is good, so green, and losing money is bad, so it will be red. And that of course means that I'm not going to enable this ticker here of color reversed. And I can also choose my preferred behaviors for the money effect. It doesn't really change much, because like I said, change in money parameter happens instantaneously. So basically, every money effect, every change money effect script works like forever. So I'm going to select it just to show you how to do it. And now I'm going to save my effect. And after saving, this effect was now added to our effects list. If I scroll down, I can find it right here, money. And when I select one effect from this list, I will be able to update it. So change anything right here, and by clicking update, this effect here on the list will be updated with my changes. So effects namespace tool enables you to add new effect scripts to your mod and set up their basic parameters. And after setting up your effects here in the namespace, you can use them in any configurator of effects in any other editor. So I would recommend, before creating your mod, to think about all the parameters that you would like to have in your game and all effects that can change those parameters, and setting them up as you feel would be right for your specific scenario. There is a multitude of effects in our game. As you can see, just for one country effects, there is over 200 of them. And there are also other categories, like province effects, or two country effects that always happen between two countries. So there is a lot of options how to use your effects and where you can use them. For my mod, I'm going to import the effect namespace file from the grand campaign scenario, and I'm going to make some small changes to how some effects work. For example, resources effects, I'm going to change their names so that they reflect other resources that I would like to have in my surviving harsh winter scenario. Instead of metal fuels and rare earth elements, I'm going to have water provisions and fuels. And this is an example of a small change that you can make in your parameters and effects to better prepare your scenario, to add some flavor and change your scenario into a desired mode. And that concludes our effects and effects namespace video. Thank you for watching, and see you next time.